The mission of this college includes 10 simple words that, in my mind, combine to form an inspiring call to action. Provide access to higher education for all who may benefit. For 50 years, the faculty and administration and stakeholders of this institution have worked to build a ladder to opportunity and to educational attainment that's affordable and accessible. The college performs irreplaceable academic, skill building, and citizen building functions, and does so with a very difficult charge. As the only open admissions institution in the city, and is the most economical option for higher education in Philadelphia. By definition, that means there will never be enough resources to meet the many challenges and opportunities in front of us. It means that we will need to be creative and innovative and single-minded. It means as much as anything that we will need incredible leadership to succeed.
Process. And if I've done, hopefully, at least two things well, as it relates to community college. One was to participate with my fellow board members in ultimately selecting Dr. Generals to be our president. And the second was, as we collectively talked about some of the challenges facing this great community college and how do we respect the work and leadership of our faculty and trying to respect that work in a way that leads to some level of increase. We're also very mindful of the increased cost of going to college. And many of us also said, we cannot continue to do our great work while increasing tuition for our students. What I said to my fellow board members in my other capacity, I will work to find additional dollars from the city of Philadelphia in order to prevent a tuition increase for this upcoming school year.
As a counselor, I get to hear from the students themselves about the tireless, round-the-clock efforts our faculty make on their behalf. I hear students excitedly describe being guided to academic discovery and to realizing potential they never knew they had. And so many times, how their lives were saved by the teacher, counselor, tutor, or librarian who cared. We are the ones who give many of our students the attention that they simply don't get anywhere else. From the moment he got here, Dr. Generals has recognized and championed the dedication and talents of our faculty. Whether in board meetings or to the people of the city as part of interviews on the radio, he has become our advocate. Although our hard work and creativity have never been about getting a pat on the back, the appreciation is, well, very much appreciated.
You see, there's a well-known motivational speaker by the name of Les Brown, and he said it best. He said, in every day, there are 1,440 minutes. That gives us 1,440 daily opportunities to create a positive impact on the lives of others. Dr. Generals, we look forward to your guidance and leadership to take this viable institution to the next level. Think of all the lives that you will indeed affect. From students to their families, future entrepreneurs to aspiring civil servants. You are even affecting the city of Philadelphia as a whole, with 93% of its graduates contributing to the workforce. Truly an accomplishment. We are confident that you will not only continue to enhance the reputation of the college, but motivate its students to continue along that path to possibilities. So on behalf of the Alumni Association and all of the alumni represented by the college, we congratulate you, Dr. Generals, on this great honor and wish you the best as the new president of the best college in the country.
The need to create a culture of completion at Community College of Philadelphia. Dr. Generals informed me that he is dedicated to improve the completion rates here at our college, and that we could count on him to support Phi Theta Kappa and our partner, the Office of Student Success Initiatives, with our C4 initiative. Dr. Generals is a man who keeps his promises. Not only is he dedicated to college completion, he is also dedicated getting to know the students up close and personal with issues and concerns they may have. He has numerous events for students to reach out to him, such as Pizza with the President, Fireside Chats, and monthly book talks.
From time to time, he and I would go out for a drink or two, and sometimes he would be my therapist, but it seems more often I was his therapist. But from these life experiences and over a course of time, I think you really get to know a person. And there are two qualities about Guy that I think really stand out and impress me. One is his passion for the things that he does. You see that in his musicianship. You see that in his athleticism. You see that in his devotion to his family. You see that in his interest in world travel to share the culture and experiences of other people. Then there's his compassion. If a person needs help, my experience has been that God will be there and be willing to help a person. I also believe that he is a believer. He believes strongly in education, how the power of education can change a person's life. And I think if you look at his professional record, his history, it shows a pattern there. And I believe that he has discovered his life's calling. And so I want to say to you, Guy, here's to life, here's to love you, man, here's to you.
This is a very challenging time for community colleges, and we have to be more strategic and innovative to address the many issues that we face. We must create better and more business partnerships to be able to respond to workforce needs. We have to become an even stronger link between K-12 students and four-year institutions. We need to identify new fiscal resources and be vigilant about our fiscal management and enrollment management practices. We must embrace data-driven decision-making, technology integration, and assessment like we've never done before. We must invest in our faculty and our staff and offer innovative experiences to ensure that we are the best that we can be. We must consume ourselves with student success and better prepare our students so that they complete their studies and are poised for better courses, jobs, and transfer opportunities. It takes a very special leader to accomplish these tasks, one who is willing and able to communicate the vision and to empower and engage members of the community for the greater good of students, the institution, and the community. You have selected such a leader in Dr. Donald Generals.
This is a poem by Robert Frost. The title of the poem is The Road Not Taken. Two roads diverged in a wood. I took the road less traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
My father's a man who made me the man I am today. A hard-working man, dedicated man to my wife. Father always taught me, work hard, you play hard. That's just what I do. I work extremely hard so that my wife and I can go on vacation. Same. Gotta get away from work sometimes, right? My father's a very competitive man, I'm sure you guys know. He likes to play basketball, he used to play tennis. When we were on the courts when I was younger, talking maybe 10, 11, 12, he would try his best. He would do his best to make sure I didn't win. You know, knock the ball out of my hand. No, you got to earn these points. And that's where my competitive comes from now. I am the same way. Like I said, I just want to say real quick, Dad, I love you. Congratulations. I am so proud of what you're doing.
Guy is a great storyteller. On a more serious note, The one thing that he is serious about is education. He never compromises his standards and values when it comes to education. I recently read Leadership on the Line by renowned leadership authorities and Harvard University faculty, Ronald Heifetz and Marty Linsky. And I was intrigued by the subtitle, Staying Alive Through the Dangers of Leading. It wasn't until the book that I considered that to lead is to live dangerously. So to conclude, I want to share a brief quote from the book. Every day you have the chance to make a difference in the lives of people around you. Every day you must decide to put your contributions out there or keep it to yourself to avoid upsetting anyone. You are right to be cautious. You disturb people when you take unpopular initiatives in your community. Put provocative new ideas on the table. Question the gap between colleagues' values and behaviors. To lead is to live dangerously. Because when leadership counts, when you lead people through difficult change, you challenge what people hold dear, their daily habits, tools, loyalties, and ways of thinking, with nothing more to offer perhaps than a possibility. Guy was meant to lead. His passion for education infuses our work and our lives. He often says that it's not work, it's his life. He boldly faces strategic questions. He makes explicit his values so that you know exactly where he is headed. He takes the heat, but is disciplined and holds steady. I have great admiration for my husband. His discipline, his outside-of-the-box thinking, his calm demeanor, his ideas, integrity. But above all, he is a great father to four wonderful children and a great husband. I want to thank you again for joining us on the start of this journey. I want to thank family and friends especially. Your presence and support mean the world to us. Thank you. Blessings.
Greetings, everyone. It's certainly great to be back with the CCP family. In preparing for this momentous occasion, I came across a passage from the book Rituals, Ceremonies, and Cultural Meaning in Higher Education, discussing what it meant to be a college president. And this fitting description, in essence, reads, and I quote, "The presidential symbol, articulations, and achievements cited mark the new president as distinctive. As the institutional logo, the president is to be larger than life. His leadership must confirm his competence, skills, and in many cases, courage. But these symbolic representations of a larger-than-life figure must be accompanied by actions that convey that he is also accessible to the community, as if to say, we want you to be extraordinary, but we want you to be one of us." It is my honor to present Dr. Donald Generals with this medallion, the symbol of the office of president of the Community College of Philadelphia. Let's get it out. Dr. Generals, are you willing to assume these responsibilities?
I am. Thank you. Congratulations.
I do formally declare you to be the sixth president of Community College of Philadelphia, with all the rights, responsibilities, and privileges thereunto pertaining. I ask you all to please welcome our president, Dr. Guy Generals, to the podium. Beyond our most celebrated graduates, there are thousands who have learned the lessons of civility, who have studied and embraced the core values of our humanities, and used their talents of critical inquiry to examine the problems in their communities, resulting in healthier neighborhoods. We've made great citizens, we've made responsible parents, and we've made Philadelphia one of the best places in the world to visit and one of the best places to live.
The city is in the throes of a massive renaissance, in part because of the education Community College of Philadelphia has provided to its citizens over the course of 50 years. However, that renaissance promises to come to a screeching halt unless we find ways to include those who are stuck among the 28% who continue to wallow in poverty and despair. This occasion has special meaning because of the historical ties between the college, the city of Philadelphia, the birth of our democratic principles, and the role education must play for us to become a more perfect union. Mere blocks from where we sit, the founders were able to weave into an endearing set of values those guiding principles that have served as the basis to the laws of this land and the aspirations we seek, which are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Although our Constitution doesn't explicitly state a prescription for education, the founders clearly understood the importance of education to the success of their grand experiment in creating government for and by the people. In 1965, in the middle of the Civil Rights Movement, now Congressman, then Street Revolutionary John Lewis reminded the nation that until such time that all citizens and residents are free from the shackles of ignorance and poverty, the revolution of 1776 is not complete. And so responding to that logic and that proclamation, the city leaders created Community College of Philadelphia. It is not a coincidence that Community College of Philadelphia celebrates its 50th anniversary at the same time that the Civil Rights Movement celebrates its 50th. The modern community college grew out of this period of social disruption, and as we celebrate our 50th anniversary in the passing of the presidential torch, we cannot lose sight, nor will I allow us to lose sight, of the relationship between the purpose and goals of this institution and the unfinished business of the civil rights movement.